PG&E has taken responsibility for last summer's Dixie Fire, admitting the flames ignited when a tree fell on the company's power lines. It was the second largest wildfire in California history. So to reduce the risk of future fires, PG&E is now putting lines underground throughout Northern California. Thanks for being with us tonight. I'm Eric Harriman. Nikki has the night off. Fox 40's Dennis Shanahan went along with crews that are doing the digging to show us where everything's going to be buried and how that potentially could change our power supply.
It started as a remote wildland fire, burning away from populated areas into the Plumas National Forest. But the flames of the 2021 Dixie Fire eventually found their way into five counties, devouring almost 1 million acres of forest, destroying hundreds of homes. And like many fires before this one, it was caused by a tree coming into contact with a PG&E power line.
That tree that fell on our line is one of 8 million trees that are in strike distance to our lines. This is an extraordinary problem.
That was PG&E Chief Executive Officer Patty Poppe speaking in Butte County last July while the Dixie Fire raged out of control. Poppe made a big promise that day.
We are committing today to undertake one of the largest infrastructure projects in the history of our state. We are committing to bury 10,000 miles of lines, starting in our highest fire threat districts and our highest risk areas. We start today.
8 months after Poppy's announcement, Fox 40 reached out to PG&E asking for a progress report.
10,000 miles of line is a trip halfway around the planet.
We wanted to know, where can we see this work actually happening?
We recently announced in our wildfire mitigation plan that in 2022, our goal is to underground 175 miles.
Utility spokesperson Megan McFarland directed us to Sly Park Road in Pollock Pines.
Jose, we're ready down here.
Right now in Pollock Pines, we are in a Tier 4 high fire threat district. So that means the risk of wildfires is pretty significant. So putting the lines underground will reduce wildfire threat and the ignition rate by 99%. So it really makes the community safer and it makes our infrastructure more resilient.
PG&E has listed 21 counties that will see undergrounding work this year, prioritizing places where the threat of wildfire is high. The counties include Amador, Butte, Calaveras, El Dorado, Nevada, Placer, Plumas, and Solano. The current cost of the work is estimated at $3.75 million per mile.
I'm actually surprised that they opted for this, which, and it's a good option, but oh my goodness, the expense. But you know, what's the expense of replacing all these homes? So.
Randy Immer lives in the Pollock Pines neighborhood we visited, an area that was threatened by last year's Caldor fire.
Now, I was evacuated for 17 days in August.
Immer welcomes the underground upgrade.
Just this morning, I'm thinking, man, I'm glad they don't have to cut any more trees down.
He and his neighbors do have to put up with some disruptions to their peaceful way of life while this work is in progress. It's dusty, it diverts traffic, and it is very noisy.
There's a bunch of rock up here, and that makes it difficult, especially for digging. That means we have to bring another piece of equipment in order to break up the rock.
PG&E is not ready to say when the 10,000-mile underground goal can be completed. It's a slow process. The work is done in 800-foot segments. The utility is aiming to finish 3,600 miles by 2026.
But when that's all over, the lines are going to be underground. It's going to reduce the risk of wildfires, and it's going to be more attractive without the overhead lines. And I think the community is going to be really happy when we're done with this project.
There's something else you should keep in mind if the undergrounding work is coming to your neighborhood. Underground power lines don't necessarily mean power poles are going away. Many of these poles also carry lines owned by cable and telephone companies. These utilities have the option of going underground with PG&E, but not all of them are opting in.
There's another reason power poles are still relevant. Transmission lines often connect to homes at roof level. Unless residents want to pay to have power lines put underground on their own properties, lines have to be run out of the ground, up a utility pole, and then from the pole to the connections on the roof of each home. In many of these cases, PG&E is replacing the old combustible wooden poles with ones like this, made of composite material.
They're stronger, they're more resilient, and they help protect communities against wildfire danger.
The digging, the burying, the connecting, and repaving all add up to an enormous undertaking that could eventually cost tens of billions of dollars. But from PG&E's perspective, it's an investment in safety. And over time, it means much less money will have to be spent maintaining above ground lines and the vegetation around them. For the residents who know what it's like to live in the path of a wildfire, the cost of doing nothing is the threat of losing everything.
Yeah, this is a good deal.
In Pollock Pines, Dennis Shanahan, Fox 40 News.
And according to PG&E, a lot of neighborhoods with underground lines would also be exempt from those public safety power shutoffs. State Senate bill aimed at speeding up those underground projects is currently working its way through the state capitol. It did already pass two major committees this spring.